सॉफ्टवेयर क्वालिटी अश्योरेंस ट्रेंड्स, वी आर गोइंग टू सी वेरियस ट्रेंड्स इन सॉफ्टवेयर क्वालिटी अश्योरेंस और SQA. द फर्स्ट वन इज योर सॉफ्टवेयर प्रोसेस. द सॉफ्टवेयर प्रोसेस इज डिवाइडेड इन टू टू टाइप्स, PSP एंड TSP. PSP स्टैंड फॉर पर्सनल सॉफ्टवेयर प्रोसेस, वेर एज TSP स्टैंड फॉर टीम सॉफ्टवेयर प्रोसेस. द नेम इटसेल्फ सजेस्ट दैट this software process is divided as either a single person or the group of person or the team of various persons. So this process is nothing but the process of software development as well as the software quality assurance. Every processes related with the software development will be treated as your software process. Let us see what is PSP and TSP. The PSP is structured software development process. It is in the structured manner. This PSP planned to help software engineers to improve their performance from predicted and actual development of code. This PSP is planned. Why it is developed or what is the necessity of this PSP? To help software engineers to improve their performance from predicted and actual development of code. Whatever predicted code is and whatever actual developed code is, this PSP helps software engineers to improve its performance on the basis of various types of codes. So the improvement in the performance is nothing but to get the more accurate output or to get the better quality software is the main aim of your personal software process or your PSP is. This PSP was created by Watts Humphrey. He was the scientist who developed this PSP process to apply the principles of CMM to the software development practice of a single developer. Yes, which I already told you that PSP will have a personal or single user. That is your single developer. So this PSP was developed by Watts Humphrey. The main aim of this PSP was to apply the various principles of CMM that we already saw in previous lecture or in previous unit. Those principles of CMM were applied to the software development practices, which is followed by the single developer only. That's why it is your personal software process. This PSP claims to give software engineers the process skills necessary to work on team software process. Yes, when various single users are combined, it will become team. That's why on the basis of PSP, the TSP has been formed. And every individual under your TSP, that is your team, will be your what? The skilled trainers, or they will be your skilled software engineers. So this PSP claims to give software engineers the process skills necessary to work on team. There will be the necessary skill, there will be the necessary training for all the person who are working under the team. What are the various objectives of PSP? Number one, to improve the estimating and plan skills. Number two, make commitments they can keep. Number three, manage the quality of their product. And number four, reduce the number of defects in their work. So the very first objective of PSP is to improve the estimating and planning skill. Whatever development will going to occur or whatever will be the development process, that development process should be properly estimated and it should be very well planned. Not a single activity should be carried out without planning. If you are not going to plan any activity, your activity will get failed. That's why the planning will be very important before starting with any of the activity. I am talking about any activity. It should not always be your software development or web application. When you are going to work on any program, any activity, then it should be your well planned. Then second one is, make commitments they can keep. You should give such commitments only when you are able to fulfill those commitments. ऐसे नहीं होना चाहिए आपने किसी को कुछ तो भी कमिटमेंट दे दिया और आप उसे वो फुलफिल नहीं कर पाओगे। यू शुड नॉट बी द पॉलिटिशियंस। मराठी में बोलते हैं ना, फक्त आश्वासन नको द्यायला, इट इज लाइक दैट ओनली। सो यू हैव टू गिव सच कमिटमेंट्स विच कैन बी फुलफिल। नंबर वन, मैनेज द क्वालिटी ऑफ देयर प्रोडक्ट्स। यस, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, द क्वालिटी ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट मस्ट बी मैनेज्ड। प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस, इट शुड ऑलवेज बी इन इम्प्रूविंग स्टेट। क्वालिटी शुड ऑलवेज बी, द ग्राफ ऑफ द क्वालिटी शुड ऑलवेज बी इन इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर, इट शुड नॉट बी इन डिक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर। रिड्यूस द नंबर ऑफ डिफेक्ट्स इन द वर्क। यस, वेन यू आर गोइंग टू अचीव द क्वालिटी, ओनली वेन यू आर गोइंग टू रिड्यूस द नंबर ऑफ डिफेक्ट्स। सो दीज आर द वेरियस ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ पर्सनल सॉफ्टवेयर प्रोसेस। लेट अस सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पीएसपी। The input to the PSP is the requirement. Yes, all the type of PSP is always going to work on the requirements. The requirement document is completed and delivered to the engineer. Whatever requirement document is there, the requirement document is collected from the customer or the user. That document is completed and delivered to the various engineers. Then engineer will going to analyze the system. They are going to plan the system, how to develop the system. Designing part will be there. Then there will be your development part. An engineer learning to integrate the PSP into his or her process begins at the level, first level, that is your PSP 0. The engineer will going to start working on this document. That engineer will going to understand what will be the customer requirement. On the basis of customer requirement, it will start integrating the system into the software development process, starting from the first level of your PSP, that is PSP 0, and progresses in process maturity to the final level, that is PSP 2.1. Yes, the various levels of PSPs start from PSP 0 to PSP 2.1. So which are those processes, which are these various levels? PSP 0, PSP 0.1, PSP 1, 1.1, 2, 2.1. So the very first one will be your 0 and 0.1. That is, it introduces process discipline and measurement. Whereas 1 and 1.1 will be your estimating and planning. And 2 and 2.1 will be quality management and design activity. So the name itself suggests that the process discipline and measurement will have various disciplines and measurement in the PSP activity. So this zero has three phases: planning, development, and postmortem. Postmortem, the name suggests that system develop होने के बाद आपको उसको क्या करना है, postmortem करना है. That means you try to identify as many errors as possible. So that is nothing but your postmortem activity is. So PSP 0 will have your three phases like this. PSP 0.1 advances the process by adding a coding standard. 0 में 0 के आगे आपका रहेगा 0.1. इसमें क्या होगा? They are going to add one more phase, that is your coding standard, a size measurement, and the development of personal process improvement plan. There will be the improvement plan. That improvement plan will help in to check whether the process is completed as per the requirement or not, or as per the designing or not. That is your 0.1. Whereas next level will be your 1 and 1.1. That is your estimating and planning. It is based on data collected in 0 and 0.1. ये जो previous के दो phases है, इसमें जो कुछ भी data collect होगा, this 1 and 1.1 will going to work on the data collected in the previous level of your PSP. Engineer estimates how large a new program will be and prepares a test report according to the data collected. So on the basis of this data collected in 0 and 0.1, the engineer will going to estimate how large the system will be. And on the basis of that, it will going to create the test report, that is your PSP 1. So PSP 1 will have the test report on the basis of data collected in 0 and 0.1. The accumulated data from previous project is used to estimate the total time. यस प्रीवियस प्रोजेक्ट और अभी का जो प्रोजेक्ट है इन दोनों का डेटा कंबाइन करने के बाद पता चलेगा एक्चुअल एस्टिमेटेड टाइम उस सिस्टम को कितना लगने वाला है, दैट इज योर एस्टिमेशन इज। ईच न्यू प्रोजेक्ट विल रिकॉर्ड द एक्चुअल टाइम स्पेंट, एवरी प्रोजेक्ट विल हैव सम टाइम एंड दैट टाइम स्पेंट विल बी कैलकुलेटेड। दिस इंफॉर्मेशन इज यूज फॉर टास्क एंड शेड्यूल प्लानिंग एंड एस्टिमेशन विच इज रिकॉर्डेड इन 1.1। 1.1 में क्या रहेगा एग्जैक्टली, टास्क एंड शेड्यूल प्लानिंग रहेगा और उसका एस्टिमेशन रहेगा। वेयर एज द पीएसपी 2 एंड 2.1 विल बी योर क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट एंड डिजाइन। दिस पीएसपी 2 एड्स टू न्यू फेजेस, दैट इज योर डिजाइन रिव्यू एंड कोड रिव्यू। द नेम इटसेल्फ सजेस्ट दैट डिजाइन रिव्यू विल गोइंग टू हैव द रिव्यू ऑफ द डिजाइन, वेयर एज द कोड रिव्यू विल हैव द रिव्यू अबाउट द कोड। The defect prevention and removal of them are focused in your PSP 2. PSP 2 में क्या होगा आपका? Error finding and error removal or defect finding, defect prevention and defect removal. That will it will going to focus on the quality management. Engineers are going to construct and use checklist for design and code review. Whoever will be the engineer assigned for this project, he is going to create the various checklists. That checklist will be based on the design and code review, that what we need to exactly check in the design. Design mein exactly kya hona chahiye? Uska wo ek kya karega? Checklist banayega aur checklist ke according that system will going to test it aur usko kya karega? One by one wo check karte jayega. That checklist will be for your design as well as code part. The PSP 2.1 introduces design specification and analysis technique. So it will have some design specification and analysis techniques. Whereas the second type is your team software process. It provides defined operational process framework designed to help teams of managers and engineers. Yes, the TSP will be helpful for the team of the managers as well as various engineers. And this team or this TSP is useful for the operational process framework which is already designed. That operational process framework will be useful for engineers and managers to execute the program or to find out the quality of the system. It is intended to improve the level of quality and productivity of teams software development project. The TSP will going to work on the improvement of the level of quality and productivity. Yes, this TSP will continuously work on improving the quality of the project or quality of the software. The initial version of TSP was developed and piloted by Watts Humphrey in 1990. Again, that same scientist have developed the initial version of TSP in 1990. The technical report for TSP sponsored by the US Department of Defense was published in November 2000. 10 साल के बाद में TSP का जो कुछ भी टेक्निकल रिपोर्ट था वो टेक्निकल रिपोर्ट पब्लिश हुआ था नवंबर 2000 में। इट वाज आफ्टर द 10 इयर्स व्हिच वाज स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय द यूएस डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ डिफेंस।